Hello everybody, this is Alexandre of Angel Cartomancy and I'm very happy to welcome you today on this new video. So today we're going to discuss an important topic which is card spread, and we're going to focus on how to give a free card spread. As you know, free card spread are the basics for Lenormand reading. And if you don't understand how to use that, it seems to be simple spread, your reading can go a little bit, you know, cloudy or muddy, and you can feel some frustration on not being able to get an answer or to get a hit in a reading. So first of all, when you use Lenormand, what is important is the context. Okay, so a card can change its meaning in different situations. Okay, think of yourself going to a party. You know, when you go to a cocktail, you will wear a tie, you will wear a cocktail dress. And when you will go to a funeral, you will put something, you know, less festive, more darker. And you will, you know, you will wear a cloth that will really reflect, you know, the situation. Same here for Lenormand. Lenormand has, you know, many meanings, and the meaning will always depend on the context. So I'm going to bring you to my table here, and we are going to do some free card readings, and I'm going to explain as clearly as possible how you will read and interpret this little spread. Okay, for this video demonstration, I am going to use my classic Lenormand. I'm going to use the larger size, which is the trump size, so that you can get a better view and understanding of the spread, okay? So before we jump in, the thing in Lenormand reading is that we always want to reply to a question. Okay, so when you have a spread before you, okay, when you have a spread before you, you should actually be able to give an answer to the question. Okay, so let's pretend that this is Mary who is asking about her love life. Okay, so the thing is, will actually Jason, okay, propose me? And what we can say here is that we, you know, shed an eye on the cards. First thing that we should do is to count how many positive cards we have and how many negative cards we have. Okay, so the lilies is considered to be quite positive. The letter is neutral. The ring, depending on the context, here we're talking about love and commitment, it can be a positive card. So we have two positive, one negative, one neutral, sorry. So straightforward, we can say yes. Okay? So try to actually know your cards, which one are positive, which one are neutral, and which one are negative. And, you know, and just reply to the question. For instance, in cartomancy, when you will reply a yes or no question, the number of red will, if there is, sorry, a number, greater number of red, the answer will be yes. And if there is a greater number of black, the answer would be no. Here, it's like the same method, but we just look at the positive cards and the negative cards, okay? So will I move to, let's say, California? So we can say straightforward that the answer is no, because we have the snake is negative, the clouds is negative, okay? The garden is quite positive, but it's clouded. Before we go into the detail reading why this person is not moving, we should answer to the question straightforward, okay? Will I get this promotion? There is, you know, two negative cards and one positive. So maybe it's a quite difficult situation. So try to get an answer from it. You know, will I get this raise? The answer is yes. There is the bouquet. The writer brings news, which are good when there is positive caught with it, you know. So this is the first thing that you should look into a free card reading, okay? So then we go to the more detail thing. When you have a free card set down, you can reply to a yes or no question, depending on the number of negative and positive cards. But we can also give like more detailed readings, you know, on the why and the when. So let's pretend that, on the question, will you become a good Lenormand reader? Okay, we're going to pull the three cards in a row. So the way that you are actually, you know, if you want to cut the deck or you want to spread it out and pick three, depends on you. Do whatever feels right for you. There is no rules about that. So let's say that you are we were talking about, will you become a better Lenormand reader? Okay, so the answer here is, I will say a little neutral, okay? Because the writer is good news when it comes with positive cards, but the mice here are not really positive. The bear here depends on the context, can be positive or not. So it's like, for me, it's more of a neutral answer. It is a maybe, okay? Then we can ask why, okay? So the writer is something that comes forward, things that come from you, something which is strong, but it is something that can be annoying or overwhelming. And the mice here is about smallness, and the bear here is about something big. So my interpretation of this card is actually, let the cards or let your intuition come forward. Have a look at the big picture and pay less detail to the small and annoying detail. Okay, so here it is asking you to actually, you know, look at the whole, like I've said in the beginning, look at the number of positive, look at the feeling that you get also when you have a reading. Your feelings always prevail on the cards, okay? The cards are like a conduct, okay? They will conduct the energy, they will conduct the guidance. And then with your feelings, with your emotions, your body will translate the what comes up in the cards. So always prevail your intuition to the cards. The cards will give you direction, but the answer is within you. Okay, so this is what you should do to become a better Lenormand reader to the Lenormand deck. That you will pay attention to the big picture instead of small annoying details and let things come forward. Don't force anything. Let it come naturally. Okay, now let's explain how the free card can be read as well in terms of focus card and adjective. So my method of reading the card is that the middle card here is always the focus, is always the current situation. And the two cards on both sides are actually, they describe the situation or they affect the situation, okay? And the last card, the third card, is my answer, okay? So let's do a reading with that. Let's say, okay, let's say that you have a new internet business and you want to know how things will go. Will it be positive or a negative venture? So we focus on the cards and we pull the three cards. Okay, So straightforward, we have two positive, one neutral card. So the answer is yes, this is a good thing. This is positive for you. The focus card here is the clover. So the clover is about new opportunity. It's about, taking the chance, twisting the fate, going against, obstacles and difficulties. And these two cards will describe or will affect this. Okay, so here we see that this person has taken the chance. And maybe along the way, he had partnered with the dog. Okay, which can be a good friend or someone who he had met, during his path with here. Okay, so the answer here is the crossroad, which is about decision. Okay, in my method of reading, if the crossroad is the last card of a reading, I always pull another card as a clarifier. A clarifier is a card that adds a little bit of more detail to something, to a reading that seems to be, there is more to it. And I will pull the card in a moment to put there to see what the decision, what the choices are. Because maybe this person is asking me this because he had got over options or over decision to take the crossroad. Maybe this person has had an offer of being, of partnership with someone. Maybe this person is thinking of hiring his best friend, okay? So now we will see, we pull a card and we put on the crossroad to see what decision, if it is positive or negative. So the garden. So the garden is about the group. The garden is also about networking. It's what face you show to the world, okay? It can be also something open to the public. So this person asking if his internet shop or business will work, the answer is yes. And he should open more to the public and take decision, not alone, but with the group. Coming here again with the dog. In my readings, my third party, my male third party is always the dog. And the female third party is the snake. Okay, this is why I never use, a double significator, like having two women card or two men card. I have decks that propose this, but in my method, I always stick to the 36 traditional because Lenormand is perfect. If the deck was made 36, it's for a reason, and it's like a fantasy to bring more people in the deck. But then the structure of the whole reading just change. Okay, the houses change because there could be two men house, and it really, affect my way of reading the card. So I stick to my 36 card and I have other cards that speak about third person, third parties. So this is how you will do your free card reading for this person. Let's do a last one. Let's take a question. Let's think. Let's say that Mary is pregnant and she wants to know if her pregnancy will be well, if her delivering the baby will be safe, and she's really stressed, so she wants to know. So I'm going to pull the three cards here. Okay, so here we are. So we have the child, we have the cross, we have the moon. So it's very nice because, the cards are, when I see a focus card that is reflected in a reading, like here we're talking about pregnancy, we're talking about child, parenting, there is the child card. So really telling me that the deck is listening to my question. I am in the reading. I'm not reading for anyone else. And the moon also is another card for pregnancy, for femininity. So here I will straightforward tell Mary that yes, she will have a good pregnancy and a good delivery. Okay. And then we go in depth because I have two positive cards. The child is positive and the moon is positive. Okay. The cross is negative. So then I can see the cross being the focus. This is about feeling the pain and feeling the burden and suffering. So maybe Mary is thinking that she is going to suffer during her delivery. Or maybe that Mary is thinking that carrying this baby is heavy and, you know, she is uncomfortable with it. It's more of a painful situation than something that is actually happy and joyful. Describing this burden, we have this two cards. So the burden is caused due to the moon, which is, you know, pregnancy, femininity, the child, both combination. It can be also because the child is growing, because the moon comes from new moon to the full moon. Okay. So, so she will deliver very well, but she can have, you know, some kind of suffering here. Maybe the baby will not want to go down as well, because the cross is, you know, something that is straight and nailed and can't move. So maybe she will need some help to deliver her baby. So in one word, this reading is positive for her. What she does need to know that there will be some pain and some suffering. And you have completely replied to Mary's question and also give more details. Okay, so now if Mary wants to know when the baby will come, it could be during a moon cycle, the new moon. Okay, it can be when the moon is waxing, because the cross is, you know, put tall and stand tall. But here I really think it can be with the new moon, because the child is small and new, and with the moon it comes to a new moon. Okay, so she may be feeling her pain of delivery right at the new moon. Okay, so this can be another detail that you can add. You see how much things that you can tell simply by pulling free cards and explaining the free cards in different always paying attention to the context. Of course, if the question was, will I get married to John? The answer will be yes again here, because the moon then become romantic and the cross here becomes something new, something just started, something fresh. But the person here should be actually super careful, because the cross is there. There is something heavy in this relationship. Maybe it's because of the partner naivety with the moon here, with the child, sorry. Or it can be, you know, about this person being like always dreaming, always not focusing on what is going on in the relationship. Okay, so remember, take the example that I said at the beginning of this video, that when you go to a special place, you wear a special clothes to the context of the situation. If you will go to a wedding, you will wear something really chic and really beautiful. If you go to the bakery, you will wear, you know, normal actually clothes. If you go to the beach, you will wear a swimming suit. So same here. The Lenormand had entered a room, and it's the room of Mary, and it's the theme of her party is pregnancy. So all the card will wear pregnancy mask, pregnancy outfit. When these cards entered a wedding situation, they will wear cocktail dresses, they will wear ties and suits, you know, high heels. And if this free card goes into a work, they will be, you know, more disciplined. as well for school. Okay, so again here, if we take the example of will I get my certification, the answer is again here yes. Okay, there had been some hard work going on here with the cross, you know, things were heavy, things were difficult, it's not an easy task. Okay, but the moon is about fame and recognition, so you are rewarded for who you are, and you are starting things, you know, you are at the step of a new beginning to the diploma that you are getting. So I hope that this video had helped you understand how to start reading the free card spread and what potential is hidden in this card and how much wisdom and answers and clarity you can pull from them. So I invite you now to subscribe to the channel, okay, to support my work. And also I wanted to share this video with people who maybe, you know, find it difficult to start with Lenormand. And if you have any question, I would like to hear them in the comments. And don't forget to grab a copy of my book, The Art of Lenormand Reading, which gives much details on how to read the Lenormand Oracle accurately. So till next time, I send you love, light, and blessings.